function and classical anatomy have a very loose relationship. So, let me explain. This is a bicep. A bicep has one function.
Так, мой бицепс, функция тому одна.
Cat heart to move. Do you know who Winnie the Pooh is, by the way? Does anyone here know who Winnie the Pooh is? Winnie the Pooh? Winnie the Pooh, the little bear, eats the honey? What's he called? Mechul Pooh. And you know Tigger? What's he called in Bulgarian?
Tigger.
Tigger. That's him. Okay, so the bicep has one function, to flex the arm.
Бицепс с говоркатан, али?
We understand that really that we then have to have a tricep to come in to extend the arm in relationship to the tricep. Okay, it's simple. We understand if I want to lift my bottle up, I have to give flexion and extension to put the arm down. There's lots of other functions involved in that. Similarly, if I abduct my arm, okay, I have muscular function associated with that.
За да вземеш шето вода, да подигна ръката си, това съчетава много мускулни функции.
If I ask you, what's your name? Krista. Thank you. Stand up for me, please. Okay. Thank you, Krista. Just turn around and face the beautiful. Come out here a minute. But never sit in the front row when I'm on the stage. Okay? Never do that again. Okay, you know now. Too late. Come stand here. Okay. So Krista, what I want you to do is I want you to lift your arm up to the side. But I
do
you know any anatomy at all? What how's your anatomy? Is it good?
Almost.
Okay, almost good. So I want you to only lift your arm up, only engaging the muscles of your shoulder girdle associated with abduction, please. Only use those arms. Okay. Now as you can see, Krista is cheating.
Криста опитва да дигне ръката, но не по начина, който той очаква. Тя лъжи. Не дига ръката с мускулите на рамото.
How do I know she's cheating?
А как разбрах, че тя лъжи?
Because she's still standing up.
Ами все още стои права.
So although the muscles of abduction are engaged, what she also has to do is she has to engage her muscles of stabilization.
Трябва да ангажира и мускулите, които стабилизират гръбнака, освен тези, които повдигат ръка.
Thank you, Krista.
Благодаря, Krista.
You're amazing. Thank you very much. Let me show you how rubbish you are at that there, okay?
Here's me abducting my arm, only using the muscles of abduction of my shoulder.
Това се случва, ако използвам само мускулите на рамото.
I haven't even had a drink. We can try this. If you do the workshop this week with me tomorrow or Friday, we'll be doing some of this. So you can feel it yourself in a minute when we have a break. If you lift your arm up and try and feel the opposite side of your body, you'll find contraction. You'll find contraction through the abdomen, through the hip, through the knee, down into the ankle.
Ще усетите, че мускулите на гърба, на таза и дори на глезените се включват в подигането на ръката.
Take one thing from here tonight. You have a client with a frozen shoulder.
Ако имате пациент с замръзнало рамо, например.
Ask them do a function test and then ask them to sit down.
Опитайте да направите функционално изследване, когато той е седнал.
And then they put their shoulder up. They say, yes, it's easier when I'm sitting down.
Те казват, ако седна е доста по-лесно.
Why?
Въпросът е защо?
Because of the stability element. The chair is now doing the stabilization that the body can't do when they're standing up. It's as simple as that. You happy with that? However, if you try to explain that to a lot of doctors, and certainly in my country, not here, but in my country, they would laugh at you. They would call you an idiot.
Повечето лекари в моята страна биха ме нарекли идиот, ако чуят това, което казвам.
So we have the basic design. We see the muscle chart and we have a basic design. Yeah?
Така че като видим таблицата с мускулната система, имаме един прост дизайн, основен.
So, is this a car?
Yes.
I've just driven around Sofia for the afternoon. There's quite a few of those out there, isn't there?
Днес се разхождах и София, видях доста такива.
I quite like look at that. Yeah. Is this a car? Yeah, it's a new one. Is this a car? Is this a car? So we've got four designs, four functional designs, four different designs, in much the same way that the human has. We say it's a car, and we can recognize the model of the car. So we can say it's a human, and we can recognize the design of a human. But which one are you? So which one were you once? I was that once. Was never that, to be honest. Which one are you? Who thinks they're a Formula One racing car? More importantly, which one will you become? And so this is what we're interested in as far as human potential is concerned. How do we become? How did you get here? Who taught you? I love this picture. I love this picture. This is a picture that we show.
Very, very popular in England.
This picture?
Post, yeah.
Yeah. It shows that this woman is stealing from this man. Look, there you go.
It could be something different also, anyway.
She's taking his wallet.
А тоя знак е навсякъде в Англия пред домовете за възрастни хора и предупреждава водачите да внимават, че бавни пешеходци може би ще се предвижат. А дали жената обира мъже или прави друго?
Look out for old women walking behind you.
Внимавайте с жените зад вас.
Okay. I'm not going to do this. This is too difficult. So we're not going to translate this. This is a piece of beautiful, beautiful English literature by a man called Thomas Hardy. And I'm not going to talk about this, but see me afterwards and I'll explain it to you. But it describes a man's face when he smiles. And I think it's the most descriptive piece of writing ever.
Ще се опитам да ви обясня нещо, което излиза от един от най-добрите английски автори, Томас Харди.
I'm sure it has been translated into every language all over the world. So it's the beginning, the opening sentence, the opening paragraph of this book, Far From Many.
Това е първото изречение от книгата на Томас Харди, Надалеч от подлудяващата тълпа.
In fact, for the right price, I will learn this in Bulgarian.
Обещавам да го науча и на български. Should I translate it then?
Do you think you could?
Когато фермерът толкова се усмихна, ъгълчета на устата му се разшириха, докато бяха на такава незначително разстояние от ушите, че очите му можеха да се намалят до точици и да се разделят пръчките, които се появиха между тях, простирайки се над неговото countenance, I can't get this one. Като очите на рудиментарен скетч от изгряващо слънце.
Fantastic. Thank you, Ivan. That's brilliant. I don't know what you said, but it's great. Countenance, his whole being, his countenance. So somebody smiles, it lights up their body. Before we go any further, I want to give credit to this man because he's a very good friend of mine, and I suggest that you look at his website and that you save up some money to get and see this guy because he's awesome. I bring him to the UK every year to do a 6-day intensive dissection. So all my inspiration for dissection, a lot of it has come from this guy, Gil Headley.
Препоръчвам ви да погледнете сайта на този човек, Гил Хедли, който е мой приятел и всяка година идва в Англия за 6 дена интензивни дисекции. Той е голяма част от моето вдъхновение да се занимавам с това, с което в момента се занимавам.
He's doing a one-day course, just a slideshow in Edinburgh at the end of July. So kill your granny to get there.
края на юли той прави дневен курс, презентация със слайдове в Единбург.
Maybe you don't kill your grannies over here about this. But we were just messing around in some ruins near my home, and Gil lives in his body. He's from Florida. He lives in his body, and you know. And check out on YouTube. Look for Fuzz Speech. The Fuzz Speech.
I'll write that. Информация за него в YouTube.
Anybody seen the Fuzz Speech? You haven't seen the Fuzz Speech? We'll do this. We'll do this tomorrow. We'll look at this tomorrow. It's cool.
Утре ще има workshop, на който тези от вас, които не са запознати с Fuzz Speech, биха могли да се ограмотят.
So this is just Gil and I messing around. You know, these are the ruins. So he's a cool guy. So just before we go any further, I just want to introduce you to Gil. So these are the new ideas. Instead of breaking the body into pieces, which is what anatomy does. So we have the guy that's the neurologist, he breaks it down into nerves. We have the guy that's the orthopedic man, he's a sort of a bone man. We have the lung guy, the respiratory guy, the you name it, the gynecologist. Let's not know what he does. We have all the people, these professions broken down. 42 specialist medical fields.
Има 42 медицински специалности по-настоящем, като идеята е, че човек не е съвкупност от системи. Новата идея е, че вместо да разчленяваме тялото на парченца, по-добре е да разберем как те са свързани.
So my idea is to start to look for connections, to start to say muscles don't exist by themselves.
Основното в моята идея е, че трябва да търсим връзката между отделните части, т.е. мускулите не съществуват като самостоятелни единици.
There are no muscles.
Няма мускули.
There is no skeletal system.
Няма скелетна система.
Sorry, Ivan.
Sorry.
You know.
I'm happy with that.
How can we have a skeletal system? You've got 208 bones in your body. None of those bones are connected to any other bones except for the connective tissue that connects them.
208 кости, които не са свързани по никакъв друг начин, освен съединителната тъкан, която ги свързва.
Let me ask Ivan. Ivan, what is the name of the specialist field that studies connective tissue in the body, please?
Should be a rheumatologist, maybe. Maybe.
Does he study connective tissue or diseases of...
Mostly the connective tissue and the diseases. Въпросът е дали има специалист, който се занимава с съединителната тъкан конкретно. Отговорът ми е ревматолог, но той не е съгласен, вероятно.
I didn't warn you about this. There are some pictures of people being cut up. Okay. So, there's no blood. So what this is a diaphragm. This is a diaphragm. So our traditional view of the diaphragm is that it finishes on our costal margin here.
Традиционното схващане е, че диафрагмата ни свършва на ръба на ребрената линия.
We're going to get a little bit technical. So tomorrow we'll talk about the diaphragm and its relationship. So here is a test to check out whether the diaphragm is just connected to the costal margin, reflected, and here is transverse abdominis.
Това е костния ръбът на долната ребрена линия, отдолу е transversus abdominis.
This is the joint. This is the thickened part of the where the rectus abdominis joins up to the transverse. Sorry, the diaphragm. So transverse abdominis. Join up, diaphragm.
И това е уплътнението сухожилно, което свързва трансверзус абдомини с диафрагмата.
So the bottom of your diaphragm is your pelvic floor.
Тоест, края на диафрагмата всъщност е тазовото дъно.
Okay. Take a big deep breath in and out. Breathe in and out. Oh, everybody's died. And we didn't notice.
Вдишите, моля ви си, им чувств, че никой от вас не е тук.
Okay, now contract your pelvic floor as if you're really needing a wee, and you may well be, I don't know.
Стиснете сега мускулите на тазовото дъно, все едно чистите, задържите малка нужда, може и да нямате нужда.
Okay, now breathe in now.
А сега опитайте, вдишите правейки това.
Harder or easier?
По-лесно или по-трудно е? Много по-трудно.
It's just contracting one bit to restrict another bit. diaphragm doesn't work in the way we think it works.
Както виждате, правейки това, всъщност пречим на функцията на диафрагмата, т.е. тя не работи точно толкова просто, колкото сме учени.
Your heart is inside your diaphragm. Your heart is actually inside your diaphragm. How can we have the heart not inside the diaphragm? Praise.
А сърцето е вътре над нея.
Did you know that on the side that the heart surgeons when they open the fibrous pericardium they don't seal it back up?
No.
You didn't know that? They don't.
Това, което не може да видим, дали знаете, че когато сърдечните хирурзи отварят гръдната клетка, те всъщност не виждат сърцето, виждат перикарда.
That's quite scary. I wish I'd known this is coming up. This is a dissection I did recently